This how you break the record. No mileage. London Hot Radio.
LondonHotRadio.com. London Hot Radio. LondonHotRadio.com.
Yeah, we're in the building. It's a Thursday afternoon. I have a special guest in the building. It's the Chop It Up with DJ Sin Show. Big up if you're listening on London Hot Radio. Shouts if you're going to tune in on Twitch, London Hot Radio, Facebook, Twitter, wherever else you find us live. So I've got a dope interview today with someone who's kind of little famous. She just got famous. She did a show called Clout Chasers. Do you like I'm a Piano, by the way?
Let's go. Let's go.
You know, you're telling me about Afronation, right?
I'm ready. I'm ready.
One tune and I'm getting into this interview.
London Hot Radio.
So I got Imogen from Clout Chasers, Stand Up TV. Stand Out TV, sorry. Shout out to Trixie. Yeah. If you know this one, hey, London Hot Radio. Hey, Thursday fire. If you know, you know. So now, shouts to Anthony Poteet, New York in the building. What's going on, New York, man? How come I ain't heard you on I'm a Piano yet, Poteet? Anyway, back to the interview. Yeah. So I have got Imogen in the building. You want to say what's up, Imogen?
Hello, what's happening?
So Imogen was on a show that I saw on YouTube. It was by Standout TV, which is called Clout Chasers, and it's hosted by Castillo, correct?
Correct.
Castillo's doing a lot of things. You see him on YouTube. Saw him at Wicked and Bad by Bouncer and them lot hosting it. So he's doing a lot of things and he's moving.
100%.
See him moving.
He's doing a lot.
Yeah. So big up Castillo. This show now, let's talk about it. So in the beginning, and if you guys haven't seen the show, you guys can go and check out the YouTube. Your episode got how many views so far?
I think it's on 355,000.
Jesus.
2 weeks ago, it's going up. If you haven't watched it, why have you not watched it? Go and watch it now. And remember that, you know, you need to watch it now.
Okay. There you go. And that's the promo for it. So scoot in a little bit. So what I was saying to you now is what made you in the first place, first of all, apply for the show or be on the show?
I thought it just would be fun. I thought good vibes. I'm always here for good vibes. I saw it advertised and I thought, do you know what it was? They said, are we looking for hot girls with banging personality? And I thought,
with
all
banging
right.
personality.
And I thought, you know what? All right, cool. Let's
They're looking
go.
For hot girls with a banging personality. Yeah.
And I was like, I feel like I might fit the category. I mean, I don't know. Let's go. So,
all right.
Yeah.
So, no, you did fit the category. I actually watched your show.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, I did. I enjoyed it. I'm not going to say everything that my perspective was on this show right now.
You look a little bit unsure, I can't lie.
No, I have to wait for like after 9 o'clock show or something to actually talk about it.
Got you.
You know what I mean?
Got you.
Kids and stuff. But it was a really good show. Go check it out. So you've gone on the show. You've seen the contestants. So what was your thought process? How did you feel about
What, with the other contestants?
Yeah.
So the way that it worked, I only saw one other girl.
Okay.
Yeah, and she came out. She said to me, oh, you're my competition. I said, no, I'm not your competition.
Okay.
You're not my competition.
All right.
So from then we were like, okay, let's go. No, but it was very lighthearted. It was very good fun. Yeah, I didn't see any of the other girls until the final.
Okay, until the final. Mm-hmm. And when you saw the other girls, yeah, what was like the energy in the room as for the final, like on the episode six, I think?
At first, we all met behind the scenes and it was like, we were all trying to, you know, when girls suss each other out, we've got to work out, okay, this person's like this, this person's like that. And then within like 2 minutes of it, we were busting jokes. It was great fun. We're all so close now. It's lovely.
No,
so the vibes were good. Straight up.
Like,
yeah.
The fact that you guys made connections and so it was really, really good.
100%.
This camera's so close to us. But
do
anyway,
you want me to take it
off?
No,
you're good.
You love it.
I can't look that way. So anyway, what I say
right in front of you. How can you not look that way?
So, when you guys, so be real now, when you guys were standing there and Castillo was about to pick one of you guys, and you know when you guys were starting to talk, like do your pitch?
Yeah.
Girls started giving their pitches out, yeah?
Yeah.
That energy there, did you, because a lot of the time, yeah, when you watch these shows, people start throwing each other under the bus.
Yeah.
But you guys didn't,
Listen, you can be prepared for it. If you're at home and you're watching it, when you're your palms are sweaty.
Like, what they're gonna say, right?
Yeah.
So, but I was actually impressed that none of the girls really dropped each other that badly under the bus.
I don't think they did really.
No,
at
they
all.
Were pretty respectful
we
even
were good
when
with
they were kind of.
I feel like it's when we met each other we realized, you know, we're in this together. You know, Castillo, he's doing his thing. We'll let him do his thing. That's fine. We don't know how the other date went. I had no idea how it went with the other girls. Right. I just knew what I had. So I think everyone felt confident in themselves.
Mm-hmm. Who was the winner?
Denalva. Yeah.
Big up Denalva. Big her up for taking the 1,000, by the way. You know where I'm coming from.
Spoiler alert if you've not watched the final.
You must have watched the final by now. But anyway.
What are you doing with your life if you haven't?
Big up Denalva for winning it and taking the 1,000. I respect that. Was you going to take the 1,000 or take the date?
I don't know. I don't know what I would have done.
What? This is what people want to really know. This is what they want to know. This is like...
I said, I went there and I said, I'm here for love.
Okay.
The £1,000 looks tasty.
Right.
But I don't know what I would have done, you know?
Okay, so let's just put it this way.
Mm.
So you've gone in for love. Mm-hmm. You guys have gone into doing a relationship. And now you're starting the second season of this thing.
Yeah, I'm taking the money because he's just going to go and find another
I'm
girl.
Just saying, like, it
was never going to not be another season if it starts with season one, is it?
I don't think there was going to be, I think there's going to be another season. Anyway, so from here, what do you, I do know that you sing, right?
Mm-hmm.
R&B music.
I do, yeah.
Are you working with anyone interesting at the moment or got any projects coming out or anything?
I am, but I'm going to keep it low for now and I'm going to plug myself later.
No problem. We've got a radio station.
There you go.
All day, every day. And then what about the other perspectives? Have you got other perspectives that have come out of this journey that you've had?
Yeah, I've spoken to a few different people. We've got a few pipeline ideas.
Nice.
We're just trying to work out what is the best thing for all of us to do. We want to keep it close and move on from the show with Castillo, do our own thing.
With the same circle.
Yeah, with the same circle of girls.
That's nice. That
yeah.
is really good.
We're very close. When I say we're very close, listen, we've got a WhatsApp group called Castillo's Angels, and we're all on there, and we chat every day.
I told them if they stick together, they might be selling like Wu-Tang Clan in a minute. I'm joking. But
joking,
anyway.
Not joking.
I'm not joking. But anyway, so podcasting.
Mm.
What do you see? I mean, with everybody today having podcasting as a huge thing, it's a big trend.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people are doing it. People are talking about on podcasts about all sorts of things they might know about, might not know about.
Mm-hmm.
How do you see podcasting today and the benefits of podcasting and the de-benefits? And also as a woman, I want you to also give a little bit of advice to women that are doing podcasts and coming up in the game. And you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, 100%.
And stuff like that.
I think there's so much out there at the moment, of course.
Mm-hmm.
And I see it very heavily influenced by a lot of men. I don't really see too many other shows just with females. And I think where we're different is we're all as individuals so different. So I think that it'll be so interesting to watch because you're not going to get the same answers with everybody, but 100. We're all calm and we're all genuine and it's nice. It's not an angry thing with different opinions. It's this and that escalates. Mm. If it's drama, it's genuine drama, if that makes sense. It's not. Yeah. So I would just say as yeah, for a woman, I think just be out there, be yourself, be genuine, and don't get led astray with stuff. Remember who you are. Enjoy doing what you're doing. Otherwise, why are you doing it?
100%. Yeah. Definitely enjoy what you're doing. Otherwise, it's just going to... It's no point. Life now. What do you... Okay, so do you see a difference after the show? Or
I was saying to you, I have to wear shades on the tube. What's happening?
Castillo changed her life, you know. Bring up Castillo for changing this woman's life. Like, she's getting recognised on planes, getting recognised on trains. Like, oh, wow.
Shout out to the crisp packet guy.
She was telling me about it. Someone recognised her on a plane from Cyprus, and then messaged her and said, "Wow, I was talking
sitting right next to you for 5 hours," and I was like, "Ah, oh, you're the guy that was digging your crisp packet into my leg for 5 hours. That's nice crazy. To see you."
That's insane. Yeah. Anyway,
what was your original question?
Yeah. So, how has life changed for you? Has it changed in much? Have you seen the differences as far as how people are treating you? How
I feel like people are funny. I feel like people are giving me more time with things.
Right.
Yeah, you know what I mean. I feel like.
And they didn't give you time before.
No.
What?
People, yeah. Well,
do you know, I was surprised because when she walked into the Castillo show, Castillo's face was like, "Wow, you're tall. Like, you are a lot."
Yeah, let's talk about this. Let's
you
clear
are
this
Amazon,
up.
Amazon rainforest tree. I was expecting an Amazon rainforest tree to walk into the studio, and she walks in, and. She's like, I was like, what?
Listen, when I walked in, there were like 5 signs saying, "Mind your head, Imogen." I'm joking.
Yo, if anybody knows the radio booth, all the DJs, all the people that have got interviewed, all the artists, you know our ceiling inside the radio booth. She fits in here. Yeah. And there's a lot of people that don't.
Do.
So she is not.
I mean, it was close. I can't.
Yo, remember. And then I didn't get it. But anyway, like.
So I am 5'11". Mm. I am a normal height. I know I'm taller than a lot of females, but I'm not huge.
No, she's not huge. Yeah. I don't know what the guys are scared about. Like just talk to her. Just be like, yo.
And I don't even really wear heels on a night out. I'm a trainer girl.
That's
so
dope.
I'm even more flat than I would be. On the show, I wore heels. So I was like, I was tall on the show. And because I was like 5'9".
You know what you need to do, though? Mm. That authority, they say. Mm. Use it to your potential and be boss with it.
100%.
You already know, you know.
I'm a force when I walk in the room.
There you go. So, boom. You get me. Look at it. Listen, I called her in here because you all know me. I build perspectives to make money. And guess what? She's a new perspective to make money. So, big herself up because she's done really well on the Castillo show. I think that she even held herself really right.
I appreciate it.
I think all the girls actually held herself right, apart from the one that was talking about eating parts of the body, which... But anyway,
she still held herself well.
She held herself well, but and she held herself well. But there's so much you're going to tell people on television or YouTube.
All I can say is I don't know how many of you have watched it, but all of the episodes were so different. Not only were we such different girls in general, every episode was different.
They were.
So we came with a different energy. There were different things to say. He was firing out different questions, and we answered in very different ways. So it's an interesting watch. Like I said,
but he did. Ask the girls different questions to who he saw the girls as, if you noticed. Yeah. Like
there were a few similar questions that ran through.
Yeah, but I think he did go left and right. So who before he did find a winner, who did you guys think was going to win?
Oh, you want the inside scoop?
Yes. I always want the inside
scoop.
Listen,
I can't lie, I thought I was going to win.
You thought you were going to win?
Because
I'm not going to lie, I thought she was going to win.
Do you know why I say this, though? Because the connection that we had... Oh, you broke my heart, and I'm playing.
All right, by the way, yeah, Castillo, she really loved you. So this is a message to you. If there is a way you can take her back, just before the next season
starts... No, it's not happening. You want to reject me, you think you can get back?
Just before the next season starts, you really did break her heart. She did have a thing for you, you know? She was throwing up the heart signs and all that.
Yeah.
And she thought that you could see who the users were and who wasn't, but...
Listen, we live and we learn.
Obviously not. Obviously not.
Radio.
Society today, it's all about, and I don't know where we're at in society, but wherever we're at, hopefully everyone's going to keep progressing, learning and evolving and making money out of this.
100%.
So, Imogen.
Go on.
I'm looking forward to music that's coming out from you.
Yeah, thank you.
Because definitely know that's going to be something cool.
100%. Keep peeled.
I'm definitely looking forward to like music videos and other stuff creatively you're putting together, because I know that you're in the video thing and you're working with different people. And I know
there's a lot happening.
Oh, I know you're gonna bring. I know you're gonna bring the fire. I know you're gonna.
Fire's always there.
Look, when everyone is scared of you, I'm not scared of you.
I can tell.
Listen, I know you're gonna bring the fire. Trust me. So you're I'm waiting for that fire. And also, if anybody wants to get Imogen on a record or anything, yeah, hit me up and I charge money. So if you hit me up, I charge money. And if you hit her Instagram up, what's your Instagram?
Imogen Official _. Getting it out there. Right, you lot ready? Get a pen, get your phone out, pull up your notes. Okay, IMOGEN Official _. He's dying over here.
Do you know, it's only been like 3 years where people have actually figured out what an _ is.
You know that little slash? I think sometimes you got to press the button. Right, let me pull my phone up now. I'm playing.
No, everyone knows what an _ is. Imogen Official _. That's where you hit up. Because if you hit me up on London Hot Radio, we are charging you money. And also, I'm telling
her... Why do you think that I'm not charging money? What's happening?
I'm just saying. I'm just telling them what's going on. Right, so okay, they cool. know if they hit me up, then, you know what I mean?
There's a fee over here.
You need money on the table.
Watch my stories. I will keep you well informed of what's happening with what I'm releasing, when, who I'm working with, what I'm doing. Yeah.
There you go. Mm-hmm. And also, she's got her own podcast coming up. Her show's coming up. They're going to be fire because their things are already lit up. So make sure you guys tune into that as well. I'm sure they're going to come with a lot of different information, entertainment stuff, and
mm-hmm. We've got
so
a lot
on
happening.
And so on.
Something for everybody.
That's good. Mm-hmm. And women progression right now.
100%.
In
look at
society.
The football.
Yeah. Exactly.
Crazy
like, what
stuff
the?
Happening.
Right, do you know what I was going to say? It's good you brought that up because England men, man, like...
There you go.
Like, really? That's where you're at right
we
now.
We did what the men just couldn't do.
Yo, and if you keep doing it, the men can't do that. That's, do you know how?
Mm-hmm.
Look, I know. Do you know the amount of women that are getting inspired to do things like football and stuff?
It's so
that's
good.
Outside the fact of just the normal occasional stuff that women get pitched to do or think that this is what they need to make it.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's great. So big up England's women team. We got all the women doing good things
it's
out
huge,
there.
It's huge.
It's huge.
Something to be so proud of. And what an inspiration for people. When they were young, obviously they would think they had no one to look up to, this, this and that. But now it's a massive thing for women. So.
Maybe you should try and get a couple of them on your podcast.
Do you know what? That's a
that
really good idea.
That would be a big idea.
That is a good idea. Come on.
This woman. You know what I'm saying? In a minute, I'm going to get the contract out. Don't worry. You know what I mean? Once the show's done, we're getting the agreement signed and all that. But anyway.
Anyway.
So, Imogen, is there anything else you want to tell the people about? Anything that you're coming up with? Anything they should look out for? Or stuff like that?
Do you know what it is at the moment? I think just look out for me in general and be ready.
Look out
I'm
for
really
her
coming with the fire, aren't
yeah,
I?
Yeah, she is coming
no,
with
do you know
the
what?
Fire.
I really like, since I've done the show, like, I've been really reacting with, or interacting, sorry, with lots of people. I really appreciate the amount of love that I've had from stuff. Mm. It's nice. I've met so many genuine people have got a lot to say. I'm meeting just different people and it's lovely, so keep bringing it in. Like, I'm interested to hear what people have got to say, interested to meet people. Let's go.
100%. And that's that's what it's about. And she has got a really good energy about her, I must say, you know what I mean? But she's a Virgo, so make sure you keep it business and keep it 100%.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Because business and 100.
If you start slacking and stuff, that it's not gonna work out. You know what I mean? So
oh gosh, we I'm ain't glad about you understand the Virgos.
Big up the Virgos. My mum's a Virgo, so all day every day. Outside music. Mm-hmm. Do you want to tell people what you do, or do you want to keep that under the cover?
Let's keep going.
Go on.
Yeah, so I'm a taxi driver. Right. If you watched the episode, then obviously you know already.
Right.
Yeah. And I also work for a pharmaceutical company as well. Okay. So, yeah, so I do quite a lot of different things, but I've always got
my fingers in the pies. Has your taxi rates gone up since the show? I would put them up. You get to speak to a celebrity in what? Yeah, come on, are you mad? This is what she's not thinking.
Do you know what
she
I've been?
Not thinking.
No, I've been doing less. I've been very busy recently. I can't lie.
Yo,
oh,
that's a premium. You do know this.
Yeah, I'm missing out,
now.
Aren't I?
There you go.
Yeah.
And
no, it's all good fun though, definitely.
And the other job you do? Tell us a little bit about that.
So basically, I'm a research analyst, so I just gather information.
So basically, she's an Essex drug dealer as well on the sideline.
I don't know where this is coming from. I turned up today. What did you say to me about how I look like I'm from Essex? And I was like, where did this come from?
Where are you from?
Where do I live? I live in Kent.
Kent.
Yeah.
That's basically Essex.
Well, so is London if you want to see it like that. Kent.
That is Essex, yeah.
I've got nothing against people from Essex, but I'm just not from Essex.
Nobody's got anything against people from Essex. Essex people are just how they are, aren't
they're
it?
Lit, so. Yeah. Love them.
You've got to take me to Essex, because. But anyway, big up Essex. Yeah, so pharmaceuticals. Tell us a little bit about that.
I literally just gather information for whichever client that I'm working with at the time. That's it. It's really interesting. I get to learn a lot about new medicines that come in first. Mm. Couldn't find anything about COVID. That they shut that down quickly.
Yeah, they did shut that down very, very quickly.
Yeah, yeah. I had no inside information even working in the industry. Anyway, but it's good. It's interesting. I like it.
Yeah, that's dope. Uh-huh. I mean, that's impressive. The fact that you're doing all of this stuff and then you go to pharmaceuticals and a taxi driver.
Yeah, you've got to switch it up. You've got to make sure you're doing what you enjoy
doing.
Again,
she's a hustler. She's a hustler.
Boy, if I told you all the jobs that I've done, you wouldn't believe me.
No, tell me.
Okay, so all right, we're here now. We're sitting down. Okay, so I used to buy and sell electrical items. I used to buy pallets and then do like different, like sell them in different places, this and that, fix stuff, sell it up, all those kind of things. I used to buy and sell cars. I can't say too much more because of the tax man.
We're still avoiding the tax man.
For real.
Crazy.
He's after us.
Crazy. So yeah, cars. Yeah.
And then like, you know, also the normal stuff, like I worked in retail, this kind
I'm
of stuff.
I'm telling you, the more I
worked in a hotel, I used to run my own
drug
hotel.
Dealer. She's a car,
hotwire cars.
What is this girl, man? I don't know. She's going to get me into trouble.
I've done a few things, but it's all good fun. And I just enjoy being out there. Like I keep saying, meeting new people, doing stuff, just being lit, basically. That's what I enjoy doing.
I big time respect that you're a hustler. I big time respect that you work really, really hard in
appreciate
your craft
it.
And yourself.
You have to.
Those are the people that I really have a lot of love and value for because... Uh-huh. I see them put in, and there's a lot of people that really wait for things to fall on their lap.
Mm-hmm. And it doesn't. And if anything falls in your lap, it's usually not the good kind of things that you want.
Not at all. So I do big you yourself up for that. And again, I'm going to have more conversations with you in future. Mm-hmm. It's not the last time you're coming on radio.
Definitely.
I just wanted to introduce you to people. I had to kind of bring you in for a meeting as well because I've got my fishing net out and all that.
Yeah. I've been trying to be reeled in.
I'm so like real with my... I should just keep my mouth closed, you know what I'm saying? When people know too much, that's when they... Nah. Anyway,
can't keep it too close.
Anything you're doing in future, I want you to come in, tell us about it, let people know about what to look out for and...
Definitely.
Add the hype, your family. Hopefully we're going to be playing London on London Hot Radio. The DJs are going to be playing her music in the close
future.
Yes,
it won't
future.
Be long, I'm telling you, it won't be long.
We're going to make that happen as well.
Hey.
So, big up Imogen, big up Castillo, big up everyone who was involved with the show.
Don't forget to go and watch the show as well.
Are we going to have the interview with the winner as well, yeah?
She's coming in.
Yep, she's going to make that happen.
She'll be here.
She's going to make
that
happen.
So don't miss that as well, because she is literally a force to be reckoned with. I'm already scared she's not here.
See, if I weren't a nice guy, she wouldn't have made it happen. But yes, I survived. One more person thinks I'm a nice guy out of everybody. Yep, good.
You're winning.
I'm winning today. So anyway.
But yeah, I appreciate you having me here, though.
No, I appreciated you coming in, spending the time, and actually talking business with me. It was very, very progressive.
Of course.
I like talking to people like that.
Mm-hmm.
I do want... Do you know what? I did want to do that. Wait.
What's happening?
No, I was supposed to do something with you originally, but I didn't have the file ready.
Oh.
So, yeah, that can't happen now.
How is everyone, though, anyway? You're having a good day. The sun's out.
Yes.
It's a nice day. I'm wearing trousers and I'm boiling.
See, she should be a radio host better than I, because that's how you radio host.
Well, I'm
you
here.
Sounded so blimmin' good.
I am.
All right, Imogen's radio show is starting next week.
Oh,
every week on London Hot Radio, so make
here.
Sure you tune in.
London
I'm going to teach her the gadgets, and we're going to keep having a wonderful day.
You're
going
to be like wondering, when are you finished? I'll be like, I'm not finished. I'm sorry.
No, I want her to carry on. I want her to keep talking crap. Podcast people like to talk crap, and they can talk crap for
See,
hours.
See, look, Harry's here now. Big up, Harry.
Oh, you noticed that?
What are you saying, Harry?
All these
What's
people
happening?
You can pick up. Harry, Yuri, Facebook user. Don't know who you are, but you're bigging up New York. Oh,
we're
I think that's
you.
Anthony. Positive Vibes. Douglas Payne. Sean Tonks. Everyone who's logged in on the radio and logged in on Twitch or wherever the hell you logged in from, big yourselves up. Love always. I'm going to finish this off. We are going to have more of her. Plus, her radio stage show starts next week, so stay locked in. Imogen Official. underscore. Don't forget the underscore. It will go to another tall girl.
Come to say.